Buddhism is a small minority religion in the Netherlands, but it has shown rapid growth in recent years. As of the 2006 estimate, 170,000 Dutch people identified their religion as Buddhist. Early history. The first awareness of Buddhism in the Netherlands can be traced back to early books, with references to Buddhism reappearing in 1651, 1843 and 1878. With the first book on Buddhism being written in the Dutch language in 1879, the turn of the century saw more popular books on Buddhism published in Dutch. Academic study of Buddhism in the Netherlands. The scientific study of Buddhism began in the Netherlands with the appointment of Hendrik Hoorn as the first professor for the chair for Sanskrit at Leiden University. He published two histories and a manual of Buddhism. Hoorn, like Emil Sennert, portrayed the Buddha as a legendary being or a hero representing the sun. Hoorn was succeeded by Jacob Speier, who translated several Mahayana texts and the Jatakamala for the series, The Sacred Books of the Buddhists. The subsequent chair, Jean-Philippe Vogel, became famous as an archaeologist by proving that Kasha in India must have been Kusinara, the place of the Parinirvana of the Buddha. He also conducted investigations on the Borobudur, the great Buddhist monument on the Isle of Java. Post-war Buddhism. After the Second World War, a strong ally for Buddhism came in the form of the Theosophists. The Dutch secretary of the Theosophical Society Adelia, Mrs. Spruitenberg, returned from India and started gatherings in her home in Huizen that attracted dozens of people from all over the country. Among them was Ernst Verwoel, who founded the Buddhistische Vriendenkring Den Haag, later renamed as Nederlandse Buddhistische Vriendenkring. He issued a simple journal. The center of the circle was in The Hague, where in 1966 the wife of the Thai ambassador, Mrs. Bedi, started receiving on Saturdays its members in the Thai embassy. Later the group was presided by Ronald Peulmeier, also being influenced by Peter van der Beek, who in 1953 became a member of the Western Buddhist Order, represented in Europe by the British Buddhist Jack Austin, National Buddhist Organization. In 1966 the Dutch Circle of Friends of Buddhism Circle changed its name to the Buddhist Society in the Netherlands. The new society held activities that were calculated liberal to all the schools of Buddhism. This ecumenical policy led to some dissension, and later the organization was revamped as the Stichting Nederlands Buddhistisch Centrum on 8 November 1967. With the aim to study of the principles of Buddhism in all its diversity and to encourage the practical application of these principles. From 1968 to the present, the center has issued a journal. Originally it was called Sadharma, and early in the 21st century it was rechristened as Vormenligte, and published together with a commercial Buddhist publisher. The center changed its name in 1978 to Stichting Vrienden van het Boeddhisme. In the same year the Boeddhistische Unie van Nederland was founded, consisting only of representatives of Buddhist groups, with Tony Kerpershoek Schuft as its first president. It was this second organization which became the Dutch member of the European Buddhist Union. Early 21st century, however, it dropped its membership of the EBU for a number of reasons, a main one being that the EBU had, and currently still has, both national umbrella organizations amongst its members as well as traditions on European level, like FPMT, Triratna Buddhist Community etc., making it in the BUN's eyes a too confused platform. From 1978 onwards, the history of Buddhism in the Netherlands is mostly the story of individual Buddhist traditions, with however the Bund still acting on their behalf towards government and NGOs, leading to e.g. the Bos Boeddhistische Omroep Stichting, and the formal Buddhist prison of chaplainship which gets equal recognition as other religions, and the SVB still being relevant as an ecumenical entry-level organization, and as publisher of the only generic Buddhist magazine available in Dutch kiosks. Zen, Chan Buddhism. In 1968, Leo Boer and Jan Willem van der Wettering founded a Zen group, and through two books made Zen popular in the Netherlands. The guidance of the group was taken over by Eric Bruin, who is still in charge of a flourishing community. There are several Zen organizations in the Netherlands. The Kansion Sangha of Genpo Roshi, having its roots in the White Plumber Sangha of Taizen Maizumi Roshi, consists of several organizations. Nico Tiedemann Sensei leads the Zen Centrum Amsterdam, which has a relatively large Zendo in the center of Amsterdam. Tenke Koppens Roshi leads the Zen River Buddhist Monastery in Uithuizen. Ton Lathouwers is the informal leader of Maha Karuna Chan, an informal and fundamentally open sangha of laypersons. Ton studied under several teachers, beginning with Masayo Abe. He received Dharma transmission from the Indonesian Chan teacher T.E.H. Cheng. Tan's teachings are characterized by an emphasis on Karuna. Another group consists of the Zen.nl organization from Rience Ritzkus, a student of Hirata Roshi of Tenryuji in Kyoto. He studied in Kyoto in 1986-87, and claimed to be officially authorized by Sokun Tsushimoto Roshi in 1999. Many other groups are also represented in the Netherlands, like the Order of Buddhist Contemplatives in Apeldoorn, the Thich Nhat Hanh Order of Interbeing and the International Zen Institute Noorderpoort Monastery, Retreat Center in Drenthe. Led by Jiun Ho Gen Roshi, Chinese Buddhists developed an own center. It is a famous landmark in the Chinatown district of Amsterdam, called the Hua Temple. It's manned primarily by monks and nuns linked to the BLIA of N. Xingyun from Taiwan, Theravada Buddhism. In 1971, the Dutch merchant Mons Hauwe gathered some people in order to discuss the possibility of founding a Theravada temple with the supportive Thai ambassador Sompong Suchritkul. In 1973, the temple was officially founded in Valwijk. Originally, the temple was named Wat Damasakari Tanakari, but 2 years later renamed as Buddharama Temple with its own supporting foundation called Young Buddhists Netherlands. This foundation had its own journal. Later, the founding abbot Ven. Mativihari moved to Amsterdam and started a separate community of Vipassana practitioners there. In 2015, it became known that Mativihari had sexually abused various of his followers in Valwijk and elsewhere. At least 21 victims had accused him of abuse by June 2015. After the passing away of N. Mativihari, there still is the Sangha Metta Buddhist Temple in Amsterdam Center. Next to this, two countrywide organizations being the general Vipassana-oriented SIM and the Burmese-oriented Sangya Ubha Khin. Also more regional organizations exist, e.g., around Groningen and Drenthe in the north of the country. Tibetan Buddhism. In 1977, Han De Witt, an authorized pupil of the Kagyu Lama Chogyam Trungpa, founded a center in Amsterdam which is engaged in teaching the Dharma and meditation according to Tibetan tradition. There is a smaller center in Oegstest, also founded by De Witt, and groups in two other towns. Other Karma Kagyu centers from different lineages have also sprung up, e.g., Naropa Institute in Kadzand, the locally famous Drupa Temple in Hantam, and Diamond Way Buddhism. The Tibetan Nyingma tradition is represented by several groups. They have a center and a bookshop in Amsterdam. These groups belong to the organization of Tathang Tulku, who resides in California. The Gelugpa tradition is organized in the Maitreya Institute and owns a retreat center in Lonen, Apeldoorn, and a city center in Amsterdam. The Maitreya Institute centers here are based on the initiative of Paula Kulkin in 1976. In August 1979, Lama Thutin Yesha and Lama Zopa Rinpoche came to teach. By 2013, Lama Geesh Sonam Gyaltsen and Lama Sonam Nodrapib are teachers in permanent residence. The Sakya tradition of Tibetan Buddhism took a foothold in 1976. His Geshe Lama Sherab Gyaltsen Amipa established the Sakya Thechen Ling in The Hague. Next to these four main schools, there are also representations of more ecumenic and split-off Tibetan groups, e.g., Rigpa from Sogyal Rinpoche, Dzogchen community from Chogyal Namhai Norbu, the new Kadampa tradition and the Jewel Heart affiliated with Jelak Rinpoche, other groups. Finally, two more ecumenic groups should be mentioned. In the first place, the Triratna Buddhist community connected with the large movement of Ven Sangharakshita in the UK. It is growing at a regular speed, with centers in Amsterdam and Arnhem and a retreat center in Hengstdijk in the southern Zeeuws-Vlaanderen region. The center in Den Haag, Boeddhistisch Centrum Haaglanden, follows roughly the same teaching but separated from the movement. Secondly, there is the Arya Maitreya Mandala, a group of pupils of Lama Vanagrika Govinda. This group had separated itself from the larger group in Germany after the death of Lama Govinda. Present situation. In 1971, there were 900 Buddhists in the Netherlands. Since 1971, the number of Buddhists has increased considerably, probably in connection with the rise of alternative views in society and the decline of Christianity. The increased interest in Buddhism is evident from the growth in number of Buddhist centers. In 1990 total, there were 42 groups. In 2010, between 80 and 100, including groups associated with a larger national center. A Buddhist broadcasting channel offers programming on the national network. In 2004, there were 170,000 Buddhists in the Netherlands, about 1% of the population. Also, the Buddhist prison chaplainship, Boeddhistische Zendendienstentie, is formally recognized by the government, gets equal subsidy as the other main religions and is busy setting up a professional training in cooperation with the Free University of Amsterdam.